Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John, this is Many a True Nerd, and welcome to Aviary Attorney, a game I've had my eye on since, oh blimey, about 9 months ago when I saw it at EGX Res, where sort of, at an initial glance, I think I named it one of my games of the show, just off seeing it very, very briefly. So, the thing about Aviary Attorney, and why I think it could possibly be the greatest game ever made, is it's because it is a law court drama set in revolutionary France, exclusively starring birds. And I think that's all we need to know. Let's start a new game, shall we? January 1st, 1848. I may have to ask Claire if that's roughly when the French Revolution is happening. The Chateau Crenier of Baron Rouguel. It's been a long time since I've said... Oh, no! Baron Rouguel! Oh, is that Monsieur Conwy? Oh, mon Dieu! Oh, the frog's dead. And the cat's upset about it. Oh, Dame Cataline's a cat. Okay, that we can do. What have you done, Dame Cataline? Act 1. A cat with claws. I love it already. Alright, and we've got ourselves Sparrowson. Now, my understanding is this is the helper figure. So now, here's the thing. When I'm doing games that involve a lot of reading, I have to pick the voices from all the characters really early on, and then sometimes I modify them later. I feel like Sparrowson is the slightly put-upon helper figure. He's going to be slightly stressed. We've got it's midday already. Where on earth is that featherhead? Well, well, well. Look who finally decided to get up. Haven't you heard what they say about the early bird, Falcon? And here's Falcon. Too early for worms. Pass the Cabaret Savillon. Alright, Falcon, a bit of a gentleman or gentle bird of respectable high tastes, I see. There'll be time for that later. We've got some business to handle first. And business? A letter arrived while you were sleeping. I haven't opened it yet. It's probably just more junk mail. Go ahead, Sparrowson. You may have the honours. Alright. Dear Monsieur Falcon, I'm writing to you today because my daughter, Dame Catalan, has been arrested for a crime she did not commit. She's being held at La Conciergerie prison on the charge of murder, no less. Her trial is in 3 days' time. I would be greatly in your debt if you would offer her your legal aid. Yours sincerely, Seigneur Pertois Demieux of the Demieux Estate. Or Demiau, I'm guessing. I'm liking it. It's full of puns. Well, this is quite something. I know, your first serious client in months. And not just that, the Demiau estate is well known for its exuberant wealth. Even if we cannot do much for Dame Catalan, his lordship would still reward us handsomely for our efforts. Well, so I suppose you intend on defending Dame Cataline in court? Of course, nope. Yes, of course we do. Apparently her family's rich. Of course, it would be foolish to let such a good opportunity slip through our feathers. Grab your coat, Sparrowson. We're going to find our kitty client at La Conciergerie. Excellent. My derriere was getting tired from all this sitting around. Oh, but I'd better file away Signor Demiau's letter first. One moment, Falcon. Pertois' letter has been added to your evidence folder. Okay, we've got an evidence folder. You may access the evidence folder at any time by clicking the suitcase symbol. Ah, nearly forgot my wallet. Wouldn't want to lose that. Again, I recall you losing it at the New Year's party, and at Christmas. Yes, all right, no need to make a list. Falcon has picked up his wallet. You can see how much money he's carrying at any time by clicking on the wallet symbol. Oh, so there's proper money in shopping as well. Nice. Let's make a move. Welcome to the map screen. From here you can travel to any listed area by clicking on a location name or a location node. Areas marked with a clock symbol take a whole day to visit. Areas with no symbol can be visited freely. Aha, I see. So obviously we've only got two things to do right now. So we've got, yep, the Aviary Attorney offices. No cases too big or too small, but from the sound of Falcon, I'm guessing quite a lot of cases might be too small if they can't afford his services and his extremely expensive taste. Or for centuries, the infamous Conciergerie prison has detained the accused and the condemned alike. Okay, before we get into this, if you're French, I'd just like to say... I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. I haven't studied French for over 10 years at this point. I'm going to get the pronunciations wrong. Let's go to the prison, shall we? Oh, I love the transitions. The artwork is just gorgeous. Falcon and Sparrowson step into the stone-cold foyer of the Conciergerie prison. Sullen-faced guards and visitors linger beneath the medieval archways. Ah, the conciergerie. They say it is the finest prison in the whole of France. The outer walls are impenetrable, the cells spotless, the guards well-mannered. What do you want? Good day, monsieur. I am here to see Dame Catherine Demiau. I am due to represent her in court. Oh, you're a lawyer, huh? Fine, fine, follow me. I don't know. I think he just went a little bit Liverpudlian. Well, what are you waiting for? Keep up! Yeah, as we've got a French cat that needs to be defended here, I think we're going to have to bring in Claire for a bit of additional voice work. So yes, we've got an appearance from Claire.
Hello. My papa has forgotten about me, has he?
Dame Catherine Demiau, I presume.
You've arrived! The fantastic lawyer, Monsieur Falcon! And his petit assistant, Sparrowson.
Milady is knowledgeable. Don't talk like that, Sparrowson. Sorry.
Mon papa told me that he would only hire the best lawyers in town.
I'm flattered.
But they weren't available at such short notice, so he hired the first people at the address directory.
Oh. You see, Falcon? I told you listing under Aviary Attorney would pay off. Let's get down to business. Dame Catherine, could you fill us in on some details? Your father's letter was a little brief.
I can do my best. What is it you wanted to know?
All right. Ooh, we've got actual things. I love it. There's actual proper... This isn't just like one of those, you know, read aloud, just kind of reading games. There's actually actual proper choice and gameplay and mystery. Okay, what happened on the night of murder? Who was there that evening? Did you see anything suspicious? Probably just best to ask what happened on the night of the murder. Yeah, okay. Let's start with that. What exactly happened on the night of the murder?
Oh, let me think. It was Friday evening. Me and mon papa had arrived at Château Crinière, the home of great Baron Rorgueil. Mon papa spent all evening talking with Monsieur Grenouille and the Baron about business stuff.
A business stuff?
Well, the three of them own a railway company together. So all through dinner, they were talking about company shares and investments, and I didn't really understand most of it. But after dinner, this man with the camera took our photographs. That was a lot more fun.
I think this character is hurting Claire's brain slightly.
Just a little bit.
Sorry, a man with a what? Took your... What? We're in 1848, by the way.
Oh, okay.
Is that year important in French history? Is that the French Revolution?
No. Camera. It's a very new gadget.
Oh, it's beautiful as well.
A tiny bug sits in a box with a tiny paintbrush and paints your picture very fast. In 10 minutes, poof! You have a perfect picture.
Wow, technology is amazing. I don't think the lady's explanation is right, Sparrowson. Psh, let me believe. Still, the camera sounds like a very special device. I'll make a note of it. Camera, add to the evidence. Please continue, Dame Catherine.
So, after we had the photograph, I went into the gardens to get some air. And that's when I found the body of Monsieur Grenouille.
Grenouille, by the way, was a giant frog or toad. I'm not sure if Grenouille is a pun in French.
Oh, yeah.
Is it? What's the pun?
Grenouille is...
Is that the
frog.
French? Is
yeah,
that frog
yeah,
in French? Okay,
frog. Yeah,
this is why Claire's useful. We can actually get some insight into the puns.
He was all ripped open. A housemaid saw me standing over the froggy monsieur and... called for help, and then the police arrived. Before I could say anything, I ended up here. Such a blur.
It must have been terrifying.
It wasn't so bad. Mon papa told me to be a brave cat. Was there something else you wanted to ask, Monsieur Falcon?
Okay, so let's find out who else was there. Mm-hmm. That's probably useful. Yeah. Dame Catherine, who attended the banquet that evening?
Well, there was me and mon papa. My dearest maman could not make it. And there was Baron Rorgueil, who hosted the dinner, and his housemaid, Coulin, I think she was called. And of course, Monsieur Grandnuit. Well, until, you know, he died. And there was Monsieur Robitio de Robinho, the man with the camera. But he was only there for a little while.
I'm suspicious of the man with the camera. Hmm.
I think that was all. Was there anything else you wanted to ask?
Did you see anything suspicious? Yes. Dame Catalina, did you see anything suspicious that evening?
Suspicious?
Maybe a guy lurking in the shadows, or a bloody murder weapon?
Monsieur Falcon, I do believe you are looking for an easy answer.
You got me.
I did not see anything, I am afraid. The evening was very normal. The food was delicious. The conversation was boring. It was all very ordinary until the incident.
I see. Wait! Falcon, you missed something of huge importance. I did. Dame Catalina, you said the food was delicious. But you didn't say what food it was! You and your damn stomach.
Let me see. We had poached red herring to start, garnished with garlic butter.
Go on.
Then a marbled steak served a perfect bloody rare.
Glorious. Falcon, write this down. What? This can't possibly be relevant to the case. Write it all down, please. For me. Fine, fine. Red herring's added to your evidence folder. This bloody red steak. Sparrison, remind me not to let you talk to clients on an empty stomach.
Come to think of it, I did find it a little strange that we weren't given any cutlery.
No cutlery? Even for the steak?
Nope. You would think that the great Baron de Chateau Crinière would have gorgeous silverware, but there was none to be seen.
That is a little peculiar.
Was there anything else you wanted to know, Monsieur Falcon?
No, I think that will be all. So, what's the plan now, Falcon? The way I see it, we have two tasks. We should head over to Chateau Crinière and try and see the scene of the murder for ourselves. And we should try and track down the supposed photographer, Monsieur Robitio de Robinho. 2 days for two tasks seems doable. And that we should get back and get some rest first. We have a lot of work ahead of us.
Wait, Monsieur Falcon, before you go. You do believe my story, don't you?
I believe you. I believe in justice. I accidentally clicked, but I believe in justice. Okay, I believe in justice. That's a good ambiguous thing to say.
Yeah.
Dame Catalina, I believe that a fair trial can draw the truth from any situation. I believe in justice.
That's good to hear.
You're not wrong, Falcon. That's not what the lady needed to hear. You might want to work on being less of a, how do you put it, fils de pute.
Well!
Claire, what can you translate, please?
Son of a bitch.
Really? Literally.
Well, son of a whore.
Son of a whore? Yeah. Wow. That's an insult you don't hear much outside of Firefly. Excellent. If serving justice makes me a fils de pute, then I'll gladly wear that title. I wouldn't say that out loud, Falcon.
I wouldn't say that to his mother.
Dame Catalina, Monsieur Grandnuit, Baron Rorgueil. These names are getting a bit confusing, aren't they? They are indeed. We should probably just start calling them cat, frog, other one. Not particularly. Well, it is for me. I'm going to start compiling a Facebook so I can keep track of who everyone is. Oh, please tell me that's actually a thing, a game mechanic. A what? A Facebook! It's a collection of people's names, pictures and descriptions in one easy-to-carry catalogue. I think I understand. A name could use a little work, though. Oh my goodness, there's actually a Facebook. And you can actually check it out. Oh, and there's Pertois de Miau, the wealthy father of Dame Catalina. Oh, that's just beautiful. Just in case you forget who's who, you've got this lovely little thing. Oh, that's glorious. Our froggy businessman who was found murdered. Okay, we need to find out who is responsible for this. Oh, there's load. Oh, wow. Okay, so I'm guessing that's like the entire game's worth of pages yet. All right, fine. Let's make a move. All right, so it's a new day, and I've only got 2 days until the trial, so I'm guessing, really, the game automatically saves at the start of each day. Fine, and you can make a quick save at any time. Lovely. So obviously, I've only got 2 days until the trial and 2 places to visit. So this is pretty much just a very quiet little walk through the case. So we've got the chateau itself, an impressive manor house with an immaculate garden where the murder took place, and the home of the photographer. Well, I'd say we should visit the scene of the murder first. That's got to be the most sensible thing to start off by doing. Falcon and Sparrowson enter the courtyard outside Chateau Crinière. People with dirty clothes and gaunt faces linger around the building's shadows.
Excusez-moi, monsieur. I don't mean to be a pain, but my little girl and I are sick and starving, see? I don't suppose you'd happen to have some spare change?
You have 20 francs in your wallet. What will you do?
I'll give a franc on the off chance that maybe they happen to have seen something.
Here you are, have a franc.
There you go, stay safe, madam.
Many thanks to you, messieurs.
That was pretty generous of you, Falcon.
Times are tough, making sure a mother and child have something to eat is the least I can do. But what am I doing standing here moralising? Come on, Sparrowson, we've got business to attend to.
Falcon and Sparrowson step into the pristine wood-panelled foyer of Chateau Cunier.
Wow, look at this place. Baron Roguel must be loaded.
More than loaded, when it comes to lucrative investments, the Baron is a legend. Factories, chocolate shops, hotels, railroads, the Baron owns a little bit of everything this side of the Seine.
Is he here right now?
Yes, he's the smug-looking chap with the impressive mane.
Oh, is he a lion?
We must approach a man of his stature with tact and finesse.
Hey, Baron, we'd like a word!
How's that? Sparrowson, you have the finesse of an inebriated warthog.
You can thank me later. I think I got his attention.
Did I hear my name, great Baron Roguel, property owner extraordinaire at your service? And who might you fellows be, more investigators?
And yes, we're police. No, we're not policemen. We're attorneys. Let's be honest.
Not quite. I'm a private attorney, J.J. Falcon, and this is my associate, Sparrowson. Lawyers, eh? You know you aren't the first to have passed through here today.
Oh?
Yes, yes, this jumpy, twitchy fellow came by this morning, asked a bunch of questions, hopped away before he heard the answers. Most curious.
Ha! Huh. Do you happen to know who he was, Sparrowson? Perhaps I have a hunch, we'll be seeing him at the trial.
A friend of yours?
Something like that.
So what may I do for you, messieurs?
We're doing some research on Monsieur Grandmoui, the frog who was killed here on Friday evening.
Of course, such a tragedy. He was a good friend and a loyal business partner. I suppose you, messieurs, will be wanting to see the crime scene for yourselves.
Yes, actually, that would be fantastic.
Well, be my guest. You'll find the garden where the murder occurred through the back doors. You may also be interested in the lounge on the second floor, third door to the right. That would be where we gathered for the group photograph prior to the unfortunate incident.
Oh, can we see the finished photograph?
I'm afraid not. It is to my understanding that the photograph needs to be developed before it can be viewed. It is a slow process. My own copy of the photograph is to be delivered in 3 days' time.
That's no use to us. The trial may be over by then.
Nonetheless, we appreciate your hospitality. Thank you, Baron. No trouble at all. I'll be here to see you out when you're done with your investigations.
So, where shall we go first?
Okay. Oh, we've got little... Look at her. It's beautiful. This game is just stunningly pretty.
All right. Let's start with the scene of the murder itself. That's got to be the most sensible place to start off. Dame Kathleen said she found Monsieur Grandmoui on the stairs by the fountain. So this must be the very spot the murder took place.
Hey, Falcon, do the crime scene investigation thing.
The crime scene investigation thing?
Yeah, you know, that thing where you get all eagle-eyed and analyse every object in excruciating detail.
You mean search for evidence?
Yeah, do that.
That's not a bad suggestion. It wouldn't be the first time the Parisian police have missed something right under their noses. In investigation mode, you're free to examine the scenery of the room. Click on an item of interest and Falcon will examine it in closer detail. Ooh. Okay. So, investigation mode. And we can look at all the individual little things, like the statues and anything that happens to be interacted with. Okay, so let's look at the fountain itself. This fountain is finely crafted. Solid carved marble. Can't have been cheap. See nothing but water in the bottom of the lower basin. Shame we can't see the upper basin from here. That would be the perfect place to quickly stash a murder weapon. That's actually not a terrible line of thinking. We ought to wade in and take a closer look, just to be sure. Yeah, I suppose we should. Oh, I apologise. I wasn't being direct enough. What I mean to say was, Sparrison, go wade into the fountain and take a closer look inside the upper basin. Me? No way. If you want to go wading, do it yourself. I'm a respectable lawyer. You can't expect me to roll up my trousers and paddle through the fountain like a duck in a lake. Yeah, well, you don't pay me enough to justify getting my sweet threads wet. Look, there's only one reasonable way to settle this. We'll flip for it. Flip for it? Oh, yep, we'll flip this one franc coin. You call the outcome, get it wrong, you go for a swim. So what'll it be? Heads or tails? Napoleon face or plant squiggles? I'll go for plant squiggles. Come on, plant squiggles. It's called a wreath, Sparrison. Sure, I'll bet on plant squiggles. Here I go. Eds, should have gone with the old Emperor Falcon. Gah, fine. Hold my shoes. Falcon should really learn how to spot a rigged coin flip. I like Sparrison. I almost feel bad for cheating. Almost. Ah, you're back. Had a nice swim? No, I'm a bird, not a fish. But I did find a mystery item in the upper basin. It's no murder weapon, though. What's this? It's brown and sticky, and it smells weird. Don't tell me you picked up a very wet cigar butt, possibly belonging to the Baron Roguel? Correct. But that shouldn't be too surprising. It is his house, after all. I'll stash it in the evidence folder, just in case. Cigar butt added to the evidence folder. Fine, we already knew that he smoked. We saw him smoking inside. Is there anything else we need to do here? Very likely, yes. Let's see what else we got. So we got a couple of statues. You know, my uncle once had a horse that refused to eat hay. Oh, that's unfortunate. Yep, eventually we realised it was just filling up on the oyster. I like you, Gabe. And of course, we've also got the spot on the stairs where the murder actually took place. This is the important bit here. Dried blood on the staircase. This must be where Monsieur Gormuy died. Do you see any bloody footprints? Oh, or maybe a name scrawled in blood written with the frog's last breath. Wishful thinking. What I'm seeing here is a big sticky puddle. There's nothing to indicate the body was moved or that the frog left a last minute clue. All I can make out from the bloody mess is that Monsieur Gormuy was attacked and killed on the stairs. Okay, I can't see anything else, so I think we should probably therefore head to the next place. I think we're done here. So, now let's head up to the lounge and see what we can learn about the actual place where the photograph was taken. So, oh, blimey! What the heck? Are you a giraffe? I like how the head of the giraffe is now completely cut off. Second floor, third door on the right. This must be the room where the photograph was taken. Psst. Hey, Falcon, did you see that? See what? That housemaid totally just did something shifty. Shifty? I think she just pocketed something from the drawer. You should totally call her out on that. Excuse me, mademoiselle. Colleen the giraffe. I don't know what a giraffe sounds like. Ah! Yes? Are you two policemen? No, we're private attorneys. My name's J.J. Falcon. And I'm Sparrowson. Oh, how rude of me. My name is Colleen de Hart. So, what can I help you, Monsieur, with today? We're investigating the murder that took place last week. Do you mind if we ask you a couple of questions? That's fine. Let me just grab a chair. That's better. What was it you wanted to ask? Now, is there something we should know? Is this where the photograph was taken? Let's start off with something easy. Is this where the photograph was taken? We're looking for the room where the photograph was taken prior to the incident. Would you happen to know whether this is the right room? Oh, yes, you're in the right place. I saw the photography session for myself. The cameraman was standing just about where you're standing, actually, Monsieur Falcon. And where was the camera pointed? Right at the clock above the mantelpiece. The Baron insists on using that very location. Now that I'm looking at it, something isn't right about that clock. I know, that painting on it totally clashed with the decor. I was thinking along more obvious lines. The clock has no hands. Oh, that clock has never had hands in all the years I've worked here. I think Barrow and Raw Girl just keeps it around as a conversation piece. Well, we're conversing about it, so I guess it's working. It's a peculiar detail, though. I'll make a note of it. Missing clock hands added to the evidence. Is there anything else you wanted to ask? Is there something we should know about something you might have just put in your pocket? You were a little bit nervous when we came in. You thought we were the police officers. Is there something we ought to know? Anything you need to confess? No, I suppose I'm just a little nervous after all the drama of the last week. Let's put some pressure on her. Are you sure there isn't anything that you're hiding? It's okay to tell us. We're defense attorneys. That means we help people get away with criminal acts. Right, and... Wait, no, that's not an accurate job description, Sparrowson. It isn't... Oh, what do we do then? I'll tell you later. Honestly, messieurs, I have nothing to hide. Was there something else you wanted to ask? Maybe I should have eased off. Never mind. Okay, that's all. No further questions. Thank you, mademoiselle. You've been a huge help. No problem, messieurs. Actually, there is... I know you two saw me stealing as you came in. I appreciate that you didn't give me the third degree about it. I did give you the third degree about it. I did the pressure option and everything. You see, I'm trying to save up to follow my dreams, and well, never mind, I'm rambling. It's no problem, mademoiselle. To be honest, we have a much larger crime to worry about. Although, I should probably ask, I don't suppose you've been stealing anything else. Silverware, perhaps? Ah, you know about that? Yes, I suppose that was me. It started with a couple of teaspoons. I didn't think the Baron would miss those. But yeah, I suppose the habit has got a little away from me. That's one mystery solved, at least. Missing silverware added to your evidence folder. I would appreciate it if you didn't tell the Baron. He's been really kind and I would hate to break his trust. You've been stealing from him! You've been routinely stealing from him. It's a bit late to break his trust. I see. So where to next, Big Bird? Well, I guess we may as well head to the main hall in that case, see if there's anything in there now we've seen all the evidence. And did you messieurs have a good look around? I trust everything was in order. We had a good look. Thank you, Baron. We actually have some questions for you. Please, ask away. I have nothing to hide. We should leave the housemaid out of it, I think. So, let's get his version of what happened on the night of the murder. Baron Rogwell, I'd like to ask about your activities on the night of the murder. Oh, am I in trouble? Not at all. No, let's put him at ease. No, nothing like that. We're just gathering the full picture. I see. Well, let me think. The guests arrived at 5 o'clock. We all sat down for dinner at this very hall at 6. That part went magnificently. The photographer arrived at 7, but it wasn't until 7:30 we had our picture taken. The housemaid discovered the crime scene soon after that. I see. Is there something else I can help you, messieurs, with? And, should we tell him about the housemaid? The housemaid could be... We've no reason to suspect the housemaid. No, I'm gonna honor the trust. I think she's been open with us, so I'm not going to turn her in. We'll be going, I think. I think that will be all, Baron. Thank you very much for your time. It was a pleasure. Have a delightful day, messieurs. Okay, we've got some circumstantial evidence, but I'm not sure anything that we can really use in the trial. Did you get all the evidence you needed, Falcon? I hope so. Don't worry. If everything goes wrong in the trial, we could always just wing it! Game of the year. Terrible. Just terrible. Let's head back to the office and get some rest. Okay. A new day begins, and we need to obviously go and have a chat with the photographer. If we can see the photo, I get the feeling that will tell us what we need to know. So this is the studio of the famous photographer. Shall we knock? Wait, there's a note on the door. Ahem. The magnificent and marvellous artist, Monsieur Rabitio de Rubinio, is currently out on an artistic expedition. He shall return when his muse sees fit. When his muse sees fit? What does that even mean? I think it means he's a pretentious bird brain. But in any case, the artist seems to be out. What shall we do now? Well, we're going to break in, obviously. We should knock anyway. Yes, we should totally knock anyway. We should knock anyway and then break the damn door down. Alright, I don't see the harm. Nope, doesn't look like he's in, Falcon. Then we're going to have to break in. We have to. We should break in. What? Are you serious? Maybe? Monsieur J.J. Falcon, I would have thought that a man of justice like yourself would be against such reckless displays of unlawful barbarism. You're right, I'm sorry, I don't know what came over. It's a brilliant suggestion. Stand back, I'm barging the door down. Oh, I love the little animation. It's beautiful. Wait, just like that, shouldn't we discuss this first? What in bird Jesus' name was that? You said you wanted to break in. I thought we could find an open window. I didn't think you'd turn into the bird-sized cannonball. Well, now we're here, we ought to make the most of it. This place is quite something. It's very... swanky? I was going to say ostentatious. Well, that's just swanky talk for swanky. We don't have time for this. The sound of the door being smashed could be drawing unwanted attention. We should find anything that might help our case and get out. Select an area to examine. Okay, we're into investigation mode. Now, where is the... where's the actual photo going to be? Ooh, what's this? I see paints, inks, and dyes. I'm not sure what the clear liquid in this bottle is. I could taste test it. You could, but we don't have time for a hospital visit right now, so let's not. So there's all these pictures on the wall, so potentially one of them might be the right picture. None of the photos are the ones we want, but you can investigate the chandelier. A chandelier! You should get one of these for the office. I don't have the money for that sort of luxury. Okay, so it's not the chandelier either. It looks like there's a way through to a different room over here. Hey, Falcon, look! What, it's just an easel? No, look what's on the easel. Ah! Oh, wow, this must be the copy of the photograph from the evening of the murder. There's no question about it. I see a housemaid, Dame Kathleen. I think that's Seigneur Pertois, Kathleen's father. Where's the Baron, though? So what do? Do we just take this? We have to take it. We need the evidence. We've come this far. We may as well borrow it. So the studio photograph's been added to the evidence folder. Is there anything else we need to do here? I don't believe so. I think we've already got everything now. Nope, that appears to be our lot. Time to head out. I think we're done snooping. Let's get out of here before we draw further attention to ourselves. Sounds good to me. Oh dear, someone's outside. Uh-oh. Oh mon dieu, what happened to my door? Tell the truth. Lie. Oh, ooh, what do we tell to the artist? The thing is, if we lie to him and we tell him that, you know, we just came across it and had already been robbed, then we won't be able to use the evidence at the trial because it'll make it clear that we actually did do the stealing. So let's tell the truth. Well, Monsieur Rubinho, it's like this. You see, we are attorneys who have been hired for the purpose of... Raven! A raven did it! We saw the whole thing. That's racist, Sparrowson. What are you doing, Sparrowson? I've got this. I'm not going to jail because your conscience is acting up. Nobody's going to jail. Just take it easy. Ugh, damn ravens. They're always after our shiny objects. You bloody racist, the pair of you. Yeah, that's right. Let's make a move. Trial day is fast approaching. Right, let's go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is all of the evidence gathered, and that means we are now ready for trial day itself. Can we find a way to clear this poor innocent cat from this appalling charge of murder of a frog? We shall see. We've gathered, hopefully, all the evidence. I really hope I haven't missed any of the evidence. I didn't kind of mess anything up with the way I questioned the Baron or the housemaid. So, on Saturday, the trial. And in the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, I've been John. This has been Many a True Nerd. And this has been the utterly charming Aviary Attorney. Thank you very much, and goodbye.
Good dodge, man. Question is, can you keep it up, cop? Oh, no, you can't. Ooh, nice. Oh, didn't quite get that one, though. We are going to the gun store in style. Oh, where's my partner? Oh, he's not here. Oh, so long, loser.